I wish you could see these huge aircraft of ours. There were people in England who did see us flying low overhead on Friday afternoon on our way to Augsburg. We Lancaster crews believe that in the Lancaster we have got the answer for heavy bombing, just as the Stirling, Halifax and Wellington crews believe in their own aircraft. We have tremendous confidence in everything about the Lancasters and in the workers who are turning them out in such numbers. We did the job. I don't feel, myself, any doubt about that, but we suffered serious losses in doing it. I was leading a formation which was unlucky enough to run into a large number of German fighters as we were crossing France. Our other formation got through to the target without being attacked at all. But four of my squadron were shot down, one after the other. There isn't very much to be said about that. The best thing is to think about the merchant seamen who won't now be torpedoed because we have bombed those sheds where the submarine engines are built. My gunners didn't let the enemy get off scot-free, but the most important thing in evading the fighters was to fly as low as you possibly could. I flew no higher than 25 feet, following the contours of the ground. You can imagine what that must have been like. 30 tons or so of aircraft, its four engines roaring, driving along at several miles a minute. Horses and cattle in the fields scattered in front of us. We saw two German officers out riding. The horses bolted and we were still out of control when we last saw them. But the big moment for me was when we came over a hilltop in Germany and saw the roofs and chimneys of Augsburg in front of us. Then the buildings of the diesel engine works. Then the big T-shaped shed of the submarine engine building plant. There it was. I'm confident that our heavy bombs went into it. The remaining Lancaster of my formation was set on fire by the flak as we were running up. But that did not prevent him from dropping his bombs as carefully and accurately as if he had not been ablaze. And this applies to the two aircraft of the other formation which were lost over the target. So all the eight aircraft which reached Augsburg found the works and bombed them, none from higher than 300 feet. Those captains and their crews, whose aircraft were blazing and who nonetheless carried on and bombed, did something that everyone can be proud of. I think the main thing in all our minds, both before and now after the operation, is that the war cannot be finished without attacking the enemy. We know that there are bound to be losses in such attacks, but today we have the right aircraft. We know that we were only sent to attack the most worthwhile targets. We believe that the way to win the war is to have our own spring offensive before Hitler has his, and in places not of his choice, but of ours.